Hi everyone, Chef Zab here. Today I want to show you a video of a Stronghold Grandmaster 3 flawless solo with the Interceptor. A lot of people actually think the Interceptor is a lot weaker than the other javelin, so I just want to show you what you can actually do with this javelin. Alright, let's get into it. I'm going to show you quickly the build I'm using first. So on this video, the build I'm using is full melee and ultimate damage. So I'm using the Deathstalker Blade. I got lucky, I've got a really, really perfect god roll on this one. This is really, really good. I got it like a couple of weeks ago, like a month ago or something. But yeah, that helps a lot for the damage with the melee. The Jarrah's Wrath I'm using for the double armor perk, so it gets a better survivability, and also if I've got some enemies stuck behind the wall or something, I can just use it and kill them behind the wall. And the Unending Battle I'm using for the 270% melee damage and weapon damage, so that boosts 170% for 5 seconds. So I'm just shooting a bullet and I've got a nice buff from it. At the end of the Stronghold toward the boss, I need the Shardstorm, which helps a lot to get the fan downs. So yeah, that's a really, really helpful. So I'm losing my armor, so I just switch to the Shardstorm, and I switch also to the Close Encounter, which I've got a 90% armor, so that helps me on the survivability, and also I can bring the fan down really, really quickly. You're gonna see. Otherwise, the Assault System is just a Serpent Veil to boost my melee damage. Nothing new about it. And the strike system, I'm using the Viper's Bite because I want to get my ultimate back quickly. Because, you know, when it gets dangerous, I want to use my ultimate. And also on the boss, this is a very, very good DPS and very helpful. So as I want to speedrun it, I want to kill the enemies. When I want to kill fast, I'm using my ultimate. And when it gets dangerous, I'm using my ultimate as well. So I'm using this a lot. Usually I use the sudden death. But on this case, on solo, it's very, very useful to get this one with the 300% charges. So you can get your ultimate back very, very quickly. And in terms of components, this is pretty much as usual. Some melee damage, ultimate damage, a little bit of armor. So that's a double armor perk. The Bloodlust to boost the melee damage. So I've got some melee and ultimate damage on it. Melee damage on the Symbiotic Surge. Ultimate damage on the Emergency Power. And the Way of the Bold to get some a source of healing. So every time I kill an enemy, I've got some armor back. So I'm using this a lot, as when it gets dangerous, I'm just targeting the little enemies, kill them fast, and that heal myself. The support system, you're gonna see the first room. I forgot I put the Voice of Courage at the beginning, so that was a mistake. That's why it took a little bit longer for the first room. I could have done it quicker, but yeah, I changed after the first room to the Slayer's Furor to send the target beacon to drop the enemy's resistance, so I can kill them faster as well. So at the boss, I had a random, I wasn't lucky, so yeah, I wouldn't put this video if the random did a lot, but I think he only done a little bit of damage on the boss after the second fan, I think. So after that, he died twice. So yeah, I'm not happy, but it's very hard on Anthem to get like a solo GM3 stronghold. So yeah, I put a video because if he was not here, if the random wasn't here, I would have finished anyway. I had my emergency power available, and I could have just done it as easy as this one. Yeah, okay, so yeah, let's go to it. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.
oceans roar and the mountains moan. Let's escape home to a place where dreams are doors you can't walk through. Flying on pure imagination, finding places where it means heaven. let me fall where I don't belong. I can't go back and lose it all.
Go, 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 go
Stop it, I love.